Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video, your function in Excel, watch the video till the end. And if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. So let's begin for the day. Today we have a topic is your function in Excel. This is a date and time function, and we are going to learn this in a much more detailed format. Now, remember one thing, that you know the Microsoft Excel, your function is a function in Excel which allows you to return the value of the year component of an entered date as a four-digit number. The four-digit number can be anywhere between 1990 to 1999, given that you know the entered value is a date value. The year Excel function is basically a built-in function and is categorized under the date and the time function of Excel. So your function in Excel can be used by both as a worksheet function and as a VBA function. So in a worksheet function, your function can be used as a part of the what we call as formula in the Excel worksheet cell. And as a VBA, you know, the year function of Excel can be used as a macro code, which you can enter through the VB editor. So normally the year function in Excel is used for extracting a year number from an entered data into the cell of the worksheet, but it can also be used for extracting and feeding a year value into another Excel worksheet formula, like date function. Okay, now how does this formula exactly look like? If you write year, you will see that there is a serial number here. So the year formula in Excel accepts the following parameters. And the arguments are like, you know, the date value, or probably over here mentioned, that's a serial number. So this is referred as the value which you have entered, and it should be valid date, which is used, which is basically then used to return the year value. Well, there's another thing that is known as the return value. Now, what is this? See, the return value in the year function in Excel will be sort of a numerical value which ranges between 1900 to 1999. Now, where exactly this is used? See, the date value entered in year in Excel must be, most important, valid Excel date in serial number format. For example, if you have entered the date, let's say Jan 1 2000, it is equal to the serial number, let's say 325506. So you should know that Excel can only handle dates after 1/1/1990 and not before that. So if you put any invalid date in the year formula in Excel, you will most probably get an error, but no valid return value. You can use a today function over here with the year in Excel to get the year from the current date as the return value. Now, how to open the year function in Excel? See, you can simply enter a desired year formula like this. You know, I'll just write year. Okay, in the required cell to obtain the return value of the argument. You can manually open the year formula in Excel dialog box in the spreadsheet and enter the required value. Like over here, you know, what you can do, you can just enter the formula over here and select from here. Basically, it's a date and time function, so you can select. If we want your function, so you can just select this. So it starts like this, and you have to put down the serial number accordingly. Now, the next thing, what we'll do, you know, I'll try and use an year function in Excel with an example to make you understand this in a much more detailed format. Let's look at some of the example of your function in Excel, and these examples will help you in exploring the use of the year function in Excel. Now, you have a couple of dates here, as like 18 Jan 89, 2009, 13, 18, and 21. So based on the above Excel spreadsheet, let's consider the example and see the year in Excel return based on the formula of year function. If I just write year over here, the serial number is this, press enter, and just press Control D. So you will get all the years in this particular date. You don't have to go and find that. You'll just get all the dates. So let's say if you have a line item, because nowadays data science and data analytics has become a very, I mean, it's a hot topic. Just for the sake that, you know, you have a data of line item of like, let's say 60,000 line items. So you know, you're not going to see for each, or you're not going to type for each. No, you just apply this ear function and you get all the details, right? So in the similar fashion, we have applied this formula and we have got the answer. So like, is equal to ear, just press this. And you don't have to write function every single time. Just select the whole row. Let's say there's nothing here. There's only this formula. So select this whole row. The Excel will consider that, you know, this is the formula you want here for this particular cell. So just press Ctrl D and you have all the values. Got it? So in the similar fashion, so what we have done is very simple. I hope you guys have got the idea. And as it has been mentioned about that, that ear in Excel can be combined with any other formula in Excel to obtain a return value such as date function. So the application of ear and date function together in Excel spreadsheet really makes sense. Now, remember one thing, the application of this ear function, this is all, it's the same thing. See, the Microsoft ear function can be used for various purposes and application within the spreadsheet. Some of the common application of the ear function in Excel spreadsheets are like, you know, data, count, converting, finding out, making a series of dates by year, okay, getting the nth day of the year, adding years to date, getting the percent of year completed, getting, you know, let's say fiscal year from the date. So these are some of the use. Now there are some common problems that one faces. See, sometimes you can face a common problem that the return value of the year function in Excel is not numerical value, but it looks like a date, such as like, you know, 1/1/1900. So most likely the problem will arise when you have your cell format set as date. So to correct this problem, you have to set the format as general here. You can go down here and change the value as general. So it will come down to numbers. Now, there are some things you need to remember about the year function in Excel. So the year function in Excel allows you to return the value of the component of an entered date as a 4-digit number. So the year function in Excel can also be used for extracting and feeding a year value into any other Excel worksheet formula, such as like date function or today function. So dates which are supplied in the year formula in Excel should be supplied as a serial number or reference to cells which have valid dates or valid date value. So you should note down that the value which is returned by the year Excel function will be a Georgian value. So they will have no relation to basically display format for the supply date value in the year formula in the Excel. So the year formula in Excel can all understand dates in all the possible formats perfectly. So if you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.